and gentlemen, and welcome to the show.
Good evening.
Shakespeare?
Hey?
Shakespeare?
I've no idea who he is, Ern. It was handed to me as I came.
To be or not to be?
What are you doing?
I was doing it then when you interrupted. I was doing it then.
Doing what?
Huh?
Doing what?
Shakespeare's soliloquy from Hamlet.
It should be the other way around.
It's these tights. There's nothing I can do about that.
To be
or not to be?
Why all the serious stuff?
Ah, well, you see, the point is that if you and I play our cards right and we do this serious stuff, we've got it made, let's face it. It's very difficult, you know. It's very difficult to come on here and do new jokes every week.
Oh, you don't have to tell me. I'm a writer.
You play your cards right. You play your cards right.
Yes.
I'll make it easy on you.
Yeah. How?
How?
How, yes.
Well, you take Olivier and Gilgood.
Who?
Laurence Olivier and John Gilgood. They're actors.
Oh, are they?
Well, they do this stuff, this rubbish, week in and week out, in the theatres, and the theatres are packed.
Are they really?
Yes.
And you mean if we could get away with that sort of rubbish, we wouldn't have to bother about writing new jokes?
Exactly. Yeah. And they charge £3 per seat.
£3 per seat?
And they don't get any laughs.
Even though they come on dressed like that. I do hope you know what you're doing.
Leave everything to me, Ern. Play it straight. That's the answer.
All right.
I tell you what, introduce me.
I'll introduce you.
Yes, and I'll go up at the back and walk down.
Actually, give make a big entrance.
Drama.
Drama.
An effect.
All right.
You won't laugh as I go up.
No, I won't. No. Ladies and gentlemen, it is now my pleasure to introduce you.
Are you doing it
now? Yes, I'm doing it now.
I can't hear you, see?
Oh, well.
I can't hear you.
Yeah, well, what should I do then?
Oh, yes.
Now, I mean, if I'm introducing you, you'll want some sort of a cue then so that you can walk down.
Thank you.
I'll give you a visual cue. What should I do?
Take your wig off.
Right now.
No, you better not. It'll get laughs. I can't talk that.
No. I'll jump up in the air, all right?
Oh, all right.
All right. Ladies and gentlemen, it's now my pleasure to introduce to you Eric Morecambe doing Shakespeare's Hamlet.
Are you going to jump up?
He wants it all.
To be or not to be? That is the question.
Thank you.
See you, Ernie.
Thank you. Thank you, Ernie. Thank you.
Wait a minute.
Just going to get changed now for King Lear.
But just a minute. What about the rest of it?
Rest of it?
Yeah, the rest of it.
What do you mean the rest of it? I've done it. He knows nothing about Shakespeare.
But that speech goes on for about 10 minutes.
Oh?
You said let's do the serious stuff, didn't you? So we won't have to do the jokes.
Yes.
Well, what are we gonna do now?
We'll go back to the old stuff. What do you think of it so far?
Rubbish!
Never fails that stuff.
Not now. Not now.
No. Slowly. Take it nice and easy.
Think of the money. Get off. My dear Keats.
Lord Byron.
2 points meet.
Oh, what a treat. May I sit down?
Please, take a seat. I do admire the poems you write.
I wrote another one last night.
And what did you call it?
The Heavenly Trumpet.
What would you like?
Have you got any crumpet?
How about you, sir?
No crumpet for me, thank you, my dear.
Between you and me, I think he's a...
I'll take some tea.
With lemon?
A slice.
And 2 pieces of cake.
That sounds very nice. The brain of the poet brightens, then flickers.
You give her 5 bob, she's sure you win it.
Pen's laid idle long enough. I'll write a poem straight off the cuff. First a swallow, then a wren. Rise and swoop, then rise again. A primrose blinks its yellow eye, but only the bumblebee knows why.
You're a genius to think of that all of a sudden. I've got one here, I think it's a good one. 2 cows eating grass on a warm, sunny hillock. I thought tomorrow that grass will be millock.
Hillock, millock, that won't work.
Of course it will, you great big burk.
Follow art, you cast a slur. I bid you good day, sir.
You're a lovely young maiden, from what I can see.
Please, will you write a poem for me?
My poem will bring you a lasting fame. I'll make a rhyme about your name.
My name, sir, is Kitty.
This letter.
Yes?
This is the pinnacle of my career.
You've passed the audition for Crackerjack.
Have you failed again? However, I don't think I'll bother doing that.
This is a letter from a firm of publishers that publish books talking about my book.
Really?
Yes, yes.
Favourable?
They think that I could become another Somerset Maugham.
Oh?
Somerset Maugham. He wrote War and Peace by Tolstoy.
I didn't know that.
You know nothing about literature, do you? Just you read that letter.
You want to hear this?
Yes, please. Oh.
I can't read that without my glasses.
You must be getting old. You must be getting old if you can't read that without your glasses.
You read it.
Yeah, okay.
Well, what are these?
Yes, please. I still can't see it. Oh, here we are. Dear Mr. Wise,
I mean that most sincerely. Most
sincerely.
Right.
Dear Mr. Wise, I have read your work, and in all my years as a publisher, I've never read anything quite like it. To say that it is verbal compost would be an understatement. Verbal compost! What a compliment that is. Isn't that marvellous? So thrilled.
You're happy with that, are you?
Oh, yes.
Verbal compost.
Verbal compost.
Well, as long as you're happy, that's the most important thing.
True, true. As a matter of fact, I've got a lady coming to see me from a well-known woman's magazine.
Really?
Yes. She wants to interview me and do my biography.
Good Lord.
A guide to young writers.
I don't want strangers coming in here and telling me how good you are. I know how good you are. You have written more belters than John Wayne shot Red Indians. I'm telling you that.
Well, she should be here any moment now.
Oh, good.
Now, you won't interfere, will you? You'll keep out of the way.
Well, out of the way.
All right.
I'll just clear this.
She'll only
be in a couple of minutes.
Right, oh, about a couple of minutes.
Got time to write the play, then?
Yes, I've got time to write another play. Put that whiskey down. Graham and I, Hank Nolan, pulled down the brim of his hat.
I walked straight into a lamppost.
Didn't want
to. How'd you do that?
What?
How'd you ring like that just when you want? How can you do
me?
It?
Me?
Eh?
There's someone at the door.
Oh, it'll be that lady then.
It'll be the lady.
Are you gonna go or shall I let you go?
No. I'll go.
Hello.
Hello. Yes, you have got to be Mr. Wise.
That's
indeed,
right.
Every inch an author.
Thank you. Thank you very much. And you are Miss...
Fanny
What did you say her name was?
Flanagan and Allen.
That's two fellas, isn't it?
Yeah, I think so. Yeah.
Sing Hometown and see what happens. Yes.
Hometown, want to wander round your banks.
Yes, I am indeed. Thank you.
Oh, good. This is Eric. Eric Morecambe. This
Hello.
Is Miss.
Flanagan Allen.
Flanagan and Allen.
Yes.
sit down. Yeah.
Do you mind if I smoke?
No, please go ahead.
Would you care for a cigarette, Mr. Wise?
No. No, thank you. I don't smoke and I don't drink.
Oh. He makes all his own dresses, though.
Do you object to a pipe?
No.
It's yours.
Oh, thank God.
I was going to give it to him, that's all.
You've read my book?
Yes, indeed. Mm. And my co-directors and myself would very much like to include it in our collection aimed at guiding the young writer.
Oh, that's very nice. You obviously know lots of famous writers, apart from myself.
Oh, yes, indeed. Yes. Solzhenitsyn.
Solzhenitsyn. Who's he? Solzhenitsyn.
Oh, he's very good.
Is he?
He translates Noddy into Russian.
Heard of him?
Alistair MacLean.
Alistair MacLean.
You use his toothpaste.
Well, obviously, I mean, they're not the same type of writer as I am. I mean, I'm an author, a proper author.
How very true, Mr. Wise.
Well, tell me, what first attracted you to my book?
You never touch on the promiscuous.
Ah, you're so right.
What's a small yellow flower blooms in spring.
Oh, well, you see, I leave all that to the archaeologists.
Archaeologists?
Yes, the archaeologists. You see, I am a writer. I have a vivid imagination, you know. I fantasize a lot.
Oh. It's a fruitcake his mother keeps sending him. That's what causes it. Fantasization.
Shut up, you. Will you? You're spoiling the whole deal, for goodness sake. I'm sorry, he irritates me very much.
I know exactly what you mean. Yes.
Well, move up now.
Mr. Wise. Yes.
I said move up.
I didn't make it in time, aren't you?
I'm trapped, I think, to the boots. Yes.
Mr. Wise, I know you are a very busy man, but I wonder, could you give me a synopsis?
Synopsis? Well, there may be one left in the biscuit tin.
No, I ate the last one last night. Little round one with jam in the middle.
Oh, he ate the last one, little round one with the jam. He scuffed a lot, I mean.
It's all gone.
All gone. Yeah.
But, I mean, if you liked my book and everything, I mean, you really do feel that it would be a good guide to young writers.
Oh, indeed. I think this could have been the passage that clinched it for me.
Really?
Oh, really?
Yes.
How are you going?
I just thought I'd stand up and read you something.
Oh, like in church.
Like yes. In church.
Very good.
You like that?
I liked it.
Good.
I like the other bit as well. Yeah. I know.
He remembered their first meeting in Paris, just outside France. They walked hand in hand along the banks of the Seine. It wasn't easy, because he was on the left bank and she was on the right.
Well, it narrows up a bit, you know, when it gets towards Lyons.
Well, you see, it's the kind of stuff our magazine is looking for.
That actually clinched it for you, didn't
it? Well, it might have been this other passage.
Yes.
Yes. He remembered how they drank coffee together outside on the pavement in Paris, and they got run over by a dust cart.
I can write poignant stuff like that by the yard, you know. That's perfect guide to young writers.
Yes, you see, no one's writing like that these days.
No, it's true. I can.
It's just the stuff we're looking for.
Yes, and that's the stuff that you're looking for, I see. Well, would you ask Miss Flanagan and Allen if she'd like coffee?
I don't think Miss Flanagan and Allen would like a cup of coffee.
She's a guest.
Oh. Would you like a cup of coffee, Miss Flanagan and Allen?
Well, how very kind. I'd love one. Thank you.
Right, I'll go and make you a cup. I'll make you a cup of instant coffee.
Thank you.
I'll be about 10 minutes.
Would you care to come and join me on the
settee? Yes, I'd be delighted.
So we can have a little chat.
Fine. You know what I mean?
Yes, right. Yes?
I thought you wanted to tell me something.
Oh, yeah. Could you
you explain all that waffle that you went through before? Could you explain that to me again while he's out of the room?
Yes, of course, happily. You see, we want to include his book in our collection aimed at guiding young writers.
Ah, yes, guiding. Now, what exactly is the angle?
Angle?
Yes.
I don't understand what you're getting at, Mr.
Well,
Morecambe.
Well, this guiding young writers, you want to use Ernie's book as a guide on how not to write a book, don't you?
Oh, Mr. Morecambe, I'm sure you and I can get around this business, and I can assure you, we would have done it in the very best of taste.
Yes, but he would have been made to look a fool, wouldn't he? Really. You know, and I mean, nobody does that while I'm around. Because I've got the concession on that. You know, I mean, you hurt me, you hurt him, you hurt him, you hurt me. One for all for one, swords in the ceiling. You know what I mean?
I do.
Yes.
Mr. Morecambe, are you also a writer?
Oh, good Lord, no.
Well, what do you do for a living?
I have a very specialised job. I'm the comedy advisor on the Des O'Connor Show. Of course, I don't work a lot.
What could you teach Des about comedy?
Timing, the art of timing.
What is the art of timing?
Well, in Des's case, getting out of the theatre before the audience.
May we get back to Mr. Wise?
Yes, let's do that. You see, it is very important, this, what I'm going to tell you now, and it's very sincere. Now, you know that he can't write. I know that he can't write. But he thinks he can. And that's good enough to me. Now, I don't want to hurt your feelings at all, and I don't wish to appear rude, but would you please leave?
In the light of that, I shall leave.
Yes,
Mr. Morecambe. Yes.
Very kind. Aren't you going to take the book?
No, with due consideration, I'm leaving it behind. Thank you.
Yeah, well, it's been very nice meeting you, Miss
Faniganella.
Yes. Oh, yeah. It's all come up.
Has Miss Lowell and Hardy gone?
Oh, yes.
Yes?
Yes, she had to go very quickly. Appendicitis.
Appendicitis? How about that? She comes to see me and then off she goes to Greece, just like this. Well, who needs her anyway?
Of course, who needs her?
I'll write another play.
Sit down and write it.
Yes, I will. Now, where were we now? Yes, yes. Aubrey was a cosmopolitan. Oh, cosmopolitan, that's a good word. K-O...
C-O.
What?
C-O.
Are you sure?
Yes.
I'll have a look in my pocket dictionary.
C-O, check. I'm telling you.
Never is. Never is. C-O. C-O. C-O, C-O-M, C-O. Compost. Compost? That's what that man said in that book, wasn't it? In the letter.
I wouldn't read that if I were you.
Yeah, verbal...
I wouldn't read that if I were you.
Verbal compost. Here we are. Compost, a mixture of various noxious ingredients which go to make manure. Manure? My work? Manure? My book is manure? Where are you going with it?
Well, put this on the roses.
Well, Edridge.
God, must be about 95.
Must be, jeez. Inspiring.
Pouring out me.
Would you, excuse me just a moment?
Sure, sure, go ahead.
It won't be long.
No.
off. Pushing us off.
And the hat's in front of the face as well.
Yeah, the hat in front of the... It's your fault. Yeah, the hat in front of the face, yes, indeed.
Beat, I just can't make it out. Just can't understand it at all. The market's down 4 points.
It's got me beat as well. Desperate Dan's just eaten 4 cow pies and he's still hungry.
This is your turn.
Yeah. Everything for the mother to be.
The clubhouse. Easy terms and 9 months to pay.
I don't feel right in this sort of place.
It's not catching. I tell you one thing, if match of the day was on every night, this place would have to close down.
It's embarrassing enough without you doing jokes.
I don't want to be embarrassed.
Hey!
What?
Why are those frocks so big?
I'll tell you about it one day. Oh. Get what you want, and then we'll go.
No, I'm embarrassed.
No need to be embarrassed, is there?
I know.
I'm with you.
I don't smoke in here.
Huh?
Don't smoke in here.
Oh, all right. Sorry.
Yes.
If it wasn't for that one little word, this place would have to close down.
Look, if you're going to do jokes, I'm leaving.
Jokes? No. See, he's highly nervous.
Oh, yes. We often find that the fathers-to-be are more nervous than the mothers-to-be.
I'm not the father-to-be.
It's his sister.
Ah.
She's the father-to-be.
It's my sister, Annie.
Well, have you anything in mind?
Well, I've never done this sort of thing before.
Sister Annie said that.
When is the happy event?
In 2 weeks' time. And stop embarrassing me.
I'll go with her.
Yes,
yes, I think you might be a little more considerate. Mm.
Just watch it. If it wasn't for me, you could be redundant.
Well, I suppose this is the right moment to get something for the little one.
The very thing that I had in mind.
but there's so much to choose from.
If you've got the saucer for this, I'll take it. Trying to take the sting out of it for you. Oh. Get what you want, then go. Uncle.
Uncle? Gosh, that's true.
Yep.
I'll be an uncle.
Of course you will.
Do you think the baby will look like me?
I don't see why not. You sell masks. Do you sell masks?
Well, I'm getting out of this place. I'll take this.
Oh, excuse me, sir. We find that usually the first thing anybody buys the little one is a rattle. Your sister's husband will already have bought one.
My sister's what?
Your sister's husband.
Husband?
Yes.
My sister hasn't got a husband. My sister's not married. As a matter of fact, my sister'll have nothing to do with men. She doesn't like men. She wouldn't let a man touch her any time, I'm telling you. I don't like that sort of thing myself either. All that nasty business that goes on. It's not nice. All that fumbling and crumbling, I know about that.
Excuse me, just a moment, please.
What's the matter?
Could I have a word with you?
Yeah.
Well, what you don't seem to understand is...
Yeah. Well, I know
how
that.
Much she's like that.
Yeah, I know.
Right?
Yeah.
Now, that's nothing to do with the new bread.
No. Well...
Rainy night.
Rainy night.
You know, the log fire, the warm champagne, the quick... Yeah.
What's that?
I've hurt my neck.
Oh. Yeah. And then the... And she... And with it... And the...
Of course.
My sister Annie did that.
What? There's got to be a father somewhere.
All right, then. Let the father buy the rattle for the baby.
I'm sorry about that. He's terribly upset. How much is it?
50 pence.
I'll take it.
All right. is, Sir Ernest?
Ideas.
No, this is sensational.
It won't be any good.
I've only said that. I haven't even seen it yet. It's a knockout idea. Yeah, no, look, I'll tell you about it. I got this idea when I was in bed.
Yes.
And I don't often get them nowadays.
No.
It suddenly came to me. So I played safe.
Yes.
And I thought about it.
Yeah, and this is a good idea, is it?
Yes.
It's new.
Never been done.
Different.
Ventriloquism.
You're going to be a ventriloquist?
If you want.
Oh, now, look, we've seen all that before. There's nothing
new. How can you say that? How can you say that in two suits? How can you say
that? There's nothing new in that at all. It's not original.
You've never seen the dummy yet?
You've got the dummy?
I'll go get it for you.
All right.
I'll only be 2 seconds.
Right, one, two, where were you?
Oh, shut up.
Oh, no, this is ridiculous. We've seen ventriloquists before. You're wasting your time. Unless there's something...
What do you think?
Well, I think you've got something there.
It's different.
Yes, it's different. I must have it. I mean, it's quite...
Let's be honest.
It's original.
What I might do, yeah? I'll tell you something.
What?
He'll be a big lad when he grows up.
Can you get him up?
Hey?
Can you get him up?
It's nothing to do with you.
All right. Right. You're going to have to tour two men in this act.
Four men in this?
Yeah.
God. What do you think?
Well,
what do you think of that?
Well, it's all right.
Eh?
It's all right.
Murder on the bus I had with him.
Took on the bus?
Yeah, murder. Well, he sat upstairs, stood downstairs.
Did you? What do you call him?
Be careful with his leg. He's sensitive.
I know. He's bow leg. What do you call him?
It's few and far between, isn't it?
Yes.
Yeah. Now then.
What do you call him?
Pardon?
What do you call him?
Hoggy.
Oh, Hoggy.
Hoggy, and he's solid oak.
Solid oak?
Yeah, I made him myself.
Did you?
You know that bit clearing in Epping Forest?
Mm.
It's him.
No.
Ask you that.
How about that?
600 squiddles without homes now.
No.
And his pockets are full of nuts.
No. Can you work it?
Pardon?
I said, can you work it?
How do you mean? How do you mean?
Make it talk.
Ah, well, I don't know. I've never tried because when he's up straight, you see.
Yeah.
When he's up straight,
yeah.
I can't get my hand on his thing. You know, the thing that you've got to pull to make his mouth work.
You mean the strings at the back?
That's a bit of a strain for me, that, you see.
Yes, yeah. Well,
yeah.
Well, you'll have to do something about it, won't you?
What can I do?
I'll get some steps.
Pardon?
I'll get some steps.
Yes.
Hold on.
Yes, I will. Yes, get some. Solid old, he is.
I made it myself. Stand on these steps.
Hey, that's a good idea.
Wait a minute, I'll get on this side.
Let's be honest. It's different, isn't it?
Oh, it is. I'm very impressed.
Hey,
I'm very impressed.
Yes, right.
Okay.
Hello, Oggy. How was school today? Really?
What did he say?
Pardon?
What did he say?
Where are you?
I'm down here. I can't hear what he says because I'm down here.
I'm sorry. I can't hear what you're saying because I'm up here.
What? Come down and tell me what
I'll
he
tell
said.
You what?
What?
I'll come down.
Right.
Okay. Right. Hold on to him.
Yes, I'm holding him.
I was getting nosebleed there.
Where are you? What did he say?
Hey. Who?
Oggy.
Oh, him.
Yes.
I said to him, how was school today?
Mm-hmm.
And he said, what was that? Roughly translated means, he ate the teacher.
Oh, did he?
Because he's a big lad.
Oh, I see. Well, look, I don't think this is going to work, you know, like this.
Well, you think so?
Well, up top of the steps is ridiculous.
Well, it's novel.
It? Yeah,
what
I know.
Way is
well, do it like the normal ventriloquist do it. You know, on a chair.
Does he?
Yes, of course. Can you hold him while I go get
I don't see why not.
All right, take
fine.
It easy.
Yeah. Solid oak, he is.
Yes, I know. I'll go
solid
oak. Okay.
Hey?
Here, I'll sit on that chair.
Lovely.
And let him lean
right.
on you. That's it, that's fine. Okay. Now you can get him around the back. Hey, wait a minute, he's getting a bit heavy for me.
Hey, he
take
is heavy,
easy, I'm only... Okay. To announce the next act.
Who is it? Ladies and gentlemen,
what was that? Who was that?
Does it really matter? Who can follow that anyway?
That's true.
Richmond and a Mr. M. Allison of Crystal Palace Road, The Stripper by David Rose.
Thank you.
everything's coming down this weekend. What time do you finish?
You stop coming out with those funny remarks all the time.
Don't like these places.
Why not?
Foot clinics.
Hey, I like this.
What is it?
Meatballs with spaghetti.
Meatballs with spaghetti and tomato sauce?
Yeah.
If my mother knew I was eating that tin rubbish, she'd turn over in a bingo hall.
Will you stop moaning?
Why couldn't we shop at the old little old corner shop? I used to like that place.
Because the little old corner shop isn't there anymore, is it? It's been knocked down. That's why.
Lovely little place. That was warm and friendly and full of character. You could take the baby in and sit it on the boiled ham. Or vice versa.
Why don't you go home and I'll carry on with the shopping?
You should be at home typing out the plays, isn't it, to make us a fortune so we can buy this stuff.
How many times do I have to tell you that I am not writing any more plays? I'm fed up with writing plays. I'm mentally exhausted. And it wouldn't worry me if I never wrote another play.
What happens if a big star comes along then?
I've finished with all the big stars. I'm resting. Not writing any more plays. Hey, I like this. This is one of my favorites.
What is it?
Chow mein.
Bachelors made that famous.
Bachelors?
I wonder why you keep me waiting.
Chow mein.
That's a one. I want that record. I tried this once.
Yeah?
Never again.
Why not?
Get me a rickshaw.
Look, can we get on with the shopping?
Yeah.
You don't mind?
Yeah.
Right.
Good wholesome food you used to get in those little corner shops.
Which shop are you talking about?
The one on Milverton Street.
Oh, yeah, I remember that.
Remember Mr. Aiken?
Yeah, very well.
I used to love watching him slicing through the cheddar with his wire cheese cutter. Remember that, when he used to go like that?
Whatever happened to him?
I don't know. The last time I heard, he joined the church choir.
In the church choir?
Boy soprano, overnight. Shook his head, didn't you?
Pilchards.
Charming.
Hello.
Hello.
Hannah Gordon.
No, Eric Morecambe. How are you? He's probably the limp. It fools a lot of people.
Hey, Eric.
Oh, that's Ernie Wise, isn't it?
No, no, that's a frozen chicken. That's Ernie Wise. The one with the head on is Ernie Wise, isn't it?
Oh, yes.
Yeah, be careful. Oh, come on.
Miss Hannah Gordon?
Yes.
Oh, my wife next door?
That's right.
I thought so.
You got that to yourself, didn't you?
Yeah.
You
never told me. I know.
Look, I really am thrilled to meet you at long last.
Well, isn't everybody? I reckon this bird will do us both very nicely over the weekend, Eric.
Don't be like that. We've only just met the young lady. What's the matter with you?
Mr. Wise, I love your work, and I was wondering, or rather, I was hoping that there might be a part for me in one of your plays.
Well, everybody's looking for a part, but I'm afraid I'm resting at the moment. Excuse me.
Resting. Hey, got some lacquer for your wig?
That's for polishing wood.
I know.
I do...
A fella's still here.
I do assure you that I am a proper actress.
Understand.
No, but I can prove that I'm...
You don't have to prove anything.
John! John!
She's calling for the manager, is she?
Oh, my darling, I love you. You will never know just how much I really love you. It simmers deep in my bosom like a volcano waiting to erupt into a fury of fire. Oh, my darling, my love for you wells up within me like the very torrents of spring. Don't leave me. Please don't leave me.
She's got a hand on your pilchards.
Would you mind taking your hand off my pilchards, please? Excuse me.
Please listen to me. Look, it's been my one ambition to appear in an Ernie Wise play. Mr. Wise, I'll be terribly disappointed.
I'm sorry, but writing plays like what I write is grueling work. And I'm exhausted.
It's tired. It's tied up.
Have you got everything, Eric?
I had the last time I looked, yeah.
Couple of tarts for after tea?
No, I'm staying in tonight.
Mr. Wise?
Miss Gordon, please, you're bothering me. Excuse me.
Well, look, well, what's come over him every other time? He's been down on his knees pleading with people to be in his place, but he won't look at me. Well, what's wrong with me?
Can I have a word with you?
Well, yes, of course.
Not here.
If you would care to accompany me over to the process, please. If Ern doesn't slacken off soon, he'll snap.
What, pressure of work?
Oh, and then some. I've been lying in bed trying to get to sleep. And I've heard him tip-tap, tip-tap on his typewriter in the other room at 2, 3, 4, 5 o'clock in the afternoon. he just doesn't want to work.
Well, then he's lost his spontaneity.
I think it's dropped off. He's only written one major work in this last 2 days.
And what was that?
The Wolfman Meets Stars on Sunday. Well, I've read it, and believe you me, there's not a funny line in it. To be quite honest, I think you're wasting your time, and nothing will make him change his mind now.
Well, I suppose I could beseech him.
If you like, take him behind the deep freeze. I'll keep an eye open for the moment.
Eric, would you get me a couple of tins of baked beans?
Shall we?
Yep. Right.
Coffee. Yep. Miss, could you tell me where the coffee is, please?
Yes, of course, just beyond the cash desk.
Well done, Ginger.
Mr. Wise, before you leave.
I'm sorry, Miss Gordon, I don't want to appear rude, but I am not writing any more major works of art, and that is final.
Hush, he.
Now,
I'm not falling for that old trick. Dame Flora Robson and Linda Japson tried to trick me like that. Yeah.
I know that, but they didn't cry till after they'd done your play, did they?
Oh, I've never been so disappointed in my life. I'm so miserable.
It's like water off a duck's back as far as I'm concerned.
Men, they're all the same. They've got no feelings. You're quite right.
Oh, God, you've got them both at it now. I'm surprised at you.
Well, why blame me? I've got a life of my own to leave, haven't I? I'm always in the wrong just because I'm little. I'm doing the best I can, aren't I? Please.
It's terrible. Do you know what you look like, don't you?
What?
You look like an audience that's just been told Des O'Connell will do an encore. There's only one way out of this mess.
Oh, what's that?
Was it you?
No.
That's a ridiculous. Was you?
Yes.
I'll write the play for you.
What?
Eh?
You write a play?
I'll write a play for Sister Anna here.
You are funny.
I say, Anna, could you imagine Eric writing a play?
Yes. I'm going back to the flat now, and I'll do it now, and I'll tell you something else.
What?
It'll be a better play than anything you've ever written, I promise you that.
Nuts!
Bilgeards! Crackers!
Ristles!
Oh. Yeah. Go to sleep, then.
Must be a hell of a size.
Excuse me. Could we have our shuttlecock back, please?
Yes. Yes.
Yes.
Come and get it. Over here. Oh. What happened there? Get it. Help yourself. Come on.
Look, we'd rather not. We've been sunbathing. You see, it's awfully private round here, and we've got no clothes on.
Oh, well. In that case, I'll bring it round for you. You're walking like that. Thank you very much. It's now my pleasure to, still warm. Introduce you now to a dance routine that Ernie did and I did, and it is a very difficult one and very dangerous.
so dangerous. It's perfectly true that the BBC actually wouldn't let us use our own legs. They actually hired our legs for us. Well, they hired mine and they lowered Ernie's.